Good evening, everyone. I'm Carmine Jimé. We start with good news following an emergency. Rock Springs sophomore Jocelyn Granado suffered a serious head injury Saturday during a football scrimmage. He was then life-flighted to Salt Lake City for emergency surgery. Doctors needed to relieve the pressure from bleeding around Jocelyn's brain. But thankfully, he's now responsive and he's recovering, exceeding doctors' expectations. The community support for the Rock Springs football player has been great. Four businesses will be selling Jocelyn Strong bracelets for $5 each to help cover the medical costs. There's also a Facebook page you can donate to called Medical Fundraiser for Jocelyn Granados. Since its creation on Monday, the page has already raised more than $6,000 of its $10,000 goal. Good luck to Jocelyn and his recovery, and we're all glad he's okay. Rock Springs and all of 4A football plays their first games a week from tomorrow. The Kelly Walsh Trojans football team opens their season at Laramie. They had 7 All-State football players last year, including our cameraman, Ishmael Perrin. But the Trojans returned just one of those All-Staters this year. They also lost starting quarterback Matt Hayes and backup quarterback Sage Coventry. So that means the Trojans have themselves a quarterback battle. It's between 3 guys, juniors Trenton Walker and Isaiah Spillane, and senior Fletcher Parrish.
Well, it's kind of tough. You just got to know that everyone's making each other better, and it's always a battle. They push me, I push them, and I mean, the best man wins.
Whenever you see them doing a good job, you just want to do good as well. You just want to use their success and make it your own.
Well, I'm definitely not trying to give anybody, I'm not cutting anybody any slack. I'm just going to do my best, not really worry about the other guys.
No more Mr. Nice Guy from the senior right there. Just up the road from Kelly Walsh tonight, the Casper College volleyball team played its season opener. The Lady T-Birds hosting Miles Community College from Montana. Casper won the first set in a close one, 27-25. Here's set point for them in the second set. Mackenzie Leong puts it up, and Ashlyn Tetenser shows a touch of class. The Laramie native wins the second set for the Lady T-Birds, and they're up 2-0. Third set now, Natrona County grad Kylie Watson serving with match point. The crowd's on its feet, and Jana Gillick is off hers. The Serbian freshman gets the winning block for Casper College. And the Lady T-Birds storm the court to celebrate their first win of the season, 27-25, 25-17, and 25-17. And afterwards, they serenaded the crowd with a song, "The Lion Sleeps Tonight" from The Lion King. Here's a Star Valley grad after her first college win.
We all get along super well. Like, I love that we celebrate like that. It just helps us get closer as a team.
It's great. You know, again, they're having a good time, and that's one thing that we're trying to encourage the group is being a family and being a team. And, you know, they are a singing bunch, and, you know, our sideline, they might not have been playing, but it takes all 15 to win, and their excitement and their cheering for their team was just fantastic.
Down in Laramie, the Mountain West cross country preseason coaches poll just came out. The coaches picked the Cowboy Harriers to finish second in the conference and the Cowgirls to come in eighth. The second place pick for the Cowboys is 2 spots better than their finish at last year's Mountain West Championship. And the Cowgirls' eighth place is exactly where they finished in the conference championship. And guys, the Polk women's soccer team is playing an overtime game against UTEP right now. Oh. Their first game of the season, and they're already in overtime.
Oh, that's going to be a fun season to watch. Yeah. Keep an eye on.
Yep.
Well, hopefully it's not as hot down there right now.
Right. I'm sure it's scorching in Texas, though. Yeah. El Paso.
That's warm.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.